I love you, Neil. Yeah! Holy fuck! Man-made hill, everybody. Randy Gagne bringing the heat. Door 23, Michael Jordan. Toronto, let me hear you. You know what the doomsday clock says? It's zero time. That's door time, baby. And we're here to bring the heat. Performance art comedy. Best show in the city, Kensington Market. We're here to party. Yeah. Okay, how many Dord fans we got in the house? Yeah, yeah, yeah. So we used to do this show every month, right? And things were humming along real good. Then along came a little movie called Bugs. Who's seen Bugs? Yeah, yeah. The major motion picture brought to you by Life of a Craphead, your host for tonight. And you know what? You might have noticed that we haven't done Dord as regular in a while. It's because Bugs was a big hit, baby. Shit has reached the stratosphere, Toronto. And you know what? I wish I could stand up here and tell you that we're the same old humble show as before, but you know what? Superstardom changes things. It's the honest truth in life and in art. So apologies to old fans. This is kind of the last version of Dord, of the old Dord that you know and love. You know, mixed emotions. I know, I know. So starting next month, we're going to have a new premium edition of Dord. Few minor tweaks. I'm just going to go over them now. You know, I generally do the housekeeping around here, so I'm just going to fill you guys in. Bit of an exclusive. You guys are at home. Live stream, how you doing? We're live. So first of all, change number one, the grocery giveaway will no longer be free. I'm so sorry. It's going to cost $100 per raffle, so you can still get in on it. But we've upped the ante. It's going to include $1,000 worth of artisanal products from around the world. We're talking salt from France, preserves from Scandinavia, well worth it. So tell your friends, tell your parents, if you want an early birthday gift, that $100 raffle ticket is well worth it. Okay, number two, do not expect us performers to be milling about during the intermission. Stardom, again, it's a bit of pressure not only to perform, but to have to socialize with you people. So we've actually installed a VIP green room somewhere in Double Double Land. We cannot disclose that location just for privacy's sake, so that's just a quick heads up. The bathrooms all have cameras in them now, just a bit of a security measure to stop bootlegging, etc. So you know, don't fuck around back there like you usually do. The intermission sculpture, sorry to local artists, we've sort of expanded our reach. They will include pieces from celebrities from Hollywood. We've got next few months figured out. We got Owen Wilson, some from Joe Perry of Aerosmith, and Demi Lovato. Okay, and starting next month, the live stream will not be shot on VHS. We moved to a very high-quality 4K stream available to premium members. It'll cost starting $19.99 a month to start off. That's sort of an early bird deal, so if you miss out on that, it'll be $50. So you're going to want to get in on that early bird deal. Stay tuned for details. Next, and finally, the bar is going to expand to include some handmade tequilas and vodkas, that sort of thing, and a small plates menu from a rotating cast of chefs. Next month's chef, Justin St. Valentine, from the very trendy Gastro Tapas Cafe. God and Sons registered provisions and canteen snack bar, so we're looking forward to that. Mixed reaction. I know change can be scary, but you're all here along for the ride with us. And if you're used to the show, you'll normally see me check the equipment using a parody song that I've written. I'm going to do that one more time this month, but next month we're going to bring in a whole crew and check it properly. A bit more boring, but hey, that's what change is all about. So you guys want to hear the final Dord parody song of all time? Woo! Remember, this is check the equipment too, so take it a bit seriously. Gita, let's do it. You know, I'm talking about movies. This is a song about my favorite movie. Snap along if you know it. Trailers didn't show no ends. Just a bunch of fake accents. Some orcs, some dwarves, some kills. They don't got Tom Bombadil. But 3 hours. Action, love, and pageantry. They're my all-time favorite movies. Lord of the Rings. First screening, midnight show. Destination, middle row.
Ian Holm played Bilbo Wright.
Hobbits run around with the ring that Frodo's uncle found. They must Lord of the Rings. All right, Gidas, I'm pretty good on my end. How are you guys doing? All mics check, right? We're looking good? All right, I totally lied about all that other stuff. It's the same old Dord you all know and love every time. But that doesn't mean we're not going to pump out the premium shit month in and month out. Ladies and gentlemen, it's Dord 23.
Yay! Hello. Hi, everybody. Thanks for coming to the show. We are Life of a Craphead.
I'm Amy. Hi.
I'm John.
This is Dord. It's a monthly performance show.
Woo!
Okay, so tonight there's going to be 7 performers with an intermission in the middle. 3 performers, intermission, 4 performers. And tonight is a special Dord because it's themed after Neil LaPierre.
For those of you who are, this is the first show, Neil is someone who's been to every Dord show for the last 3 years.
He's performed
at every Dord show. The only person that performed at every Dord show
is Neil.
Is Neil? Glenn went to a wedding one time, I think, and Bridget went to Italy, I think. Is that right? And yeah, so Neil is the only one that's done them all. And so this show has Neil-themed content. But don't worry if you haven't seen Neil before, I don't know who we're talking about. There's other content as well.
But first, for the Neil-themed content, so we've assembled a walk down memory path to look back in time at Neil over the years as he's performed since December 2012, almost every month. So,
okay, so here we go.
This is Neil at Dord 1. Neil at Dord 2. Neil at Dord 3. Neil at Dord 4. Neil at Dord 5.
So little.
Neil at Dord 6. This is Neil at Dord
Angsty.
7. Dord 8, Neil. Dord 9, Neil. This is in like the 2013s by now. Maybe 2014 even. Neil at Dord 10. Neil at Dord 11. Neil at Dord 12. Neil at Dord 13. Dord 14, Neil.
He's getting older.
Neil at Dord 15 has new glasses. Neil at Dord 15 as Bridget. Neil at Dord 16. Neil at Dord 17. Neil at Dord 18.
Let's just be like 19, 20, 21, 22.
That picture.
And that's it. Round of applause for Neil. Great. So we did that planned part. Really, Dord is just a show about watching people age. Watch everyone get older and older.
Okay. So that's the Neil-themed Dord. But John and I, personally, Life of a Craphead, we have something, I guess, to clear up from last time that may have been not true.
We need to come clean. Last time, we said that Amy was in Europe and operating this light. Does anybody remember that joke?
Oh,
well, Amy was actually not in Europe, and the light was played by an actor.
Mm-hmm. the light was an actor. So the light was an actor, and after the show, I guess the light contacted John.
So the light did the show, and everyone loved it. And well, I loved it. And the actor went to the Dord Tumblr page and got into the idea of Dord, and then asked if they could perform at Dord, and so we said yes. Dord is a multimedia show. We have performance and poetry sometimes, and music.
We have sculpture.
Randy's sculpture.
We
in
have
the break. We have groceries. So we're going to also have acting.
Yeah. Why not have acting? So the actor is going to present what is it called?
A monologue.
A monologue.
Are you guys
monologue.
Excited about that? Do you want to see the actor played Amy do a monologue? Sounds like they want to see it.
Great. So here is the actor box. That was the actor box. Let's give it up for the actor box. That was the monologue. So yeah, now we're gonna start the show. Our first act is Vida Bear.
Don't be so ashamed. You've had mine, we've had yours. We both know. We know. They will get like I will. My only wish is I die real. Those truths hurt and those lies heal. You can't sleep thinking that he lies still. So you lie still. Tears all in the pillowcase. Big girls all get a little taste. You're pushing me away, talking for space. dealing with a heart that isn't big. I'll be there for you. I will care for you. I keep thinking you just don't know. Say, trying to run from that. Say you're done with that. On your face, girl, it just don't show. When you're ready, just say you're ready. And all the baggage just ain't as heavy. And the party's over. Just don't forget me. We'll change the pace and you just go slow. You won't ever have to worry. You won't ever have to hide. You've seen all my mistakes. So look me in my eye. Cause if you let me, here's what I'll do. I'll take care of you. I've loved and I've lost. It's my birthday, I'll get high if I want to. Can't deny that I want you, but I lie if I have to. Cause you don't say you love me to your friends when they ask you. Even though we both know that you do, you do. One time, been in love one time. You and all your girls in the club one time. All so convinced that you're following your heart, but your mind don't control what it does. Sometimes we all have our nights, so don't be so ashamed. I've had mine, you've had yours, we both know. You hate being alone, but you're not the only one. You hate the fact that I bought the drink when they sold you one. You love your friends, but you wish somebody would have told you something to save you. Instead, they say. By someone else, I can tell by the way you carry yourself. But if you let me, here's what I'll do. I'll take care of you. I've loved and I've lost.
Vita Bear.
Let's hear it for Vita, everybody.
And our next act is Aisha Sasha John. Isa Sasha John. She's a dancer and an amazing poet as well. Okay.
What do you think she was listening to, Amy?
I don't know.
This stuff made me think it was probably dance music. Right? Right? Okay, let's hear it for the next act, Bridget Moser.
What are you drinking? I can't stay is what I'm saying. I don't do blind dates. My parents met on a blind date, and they've been inseparable ever since. Well, I'm happy for your parents and for you because it means that you exist, but I don't do blind dates. This isn't a blind date. What? It's a job interview. What are you drinking? Dirty martini. What do you mean this is a job interview? This is a job interview. Then why aren't we in an office or some kind of open concept workspace? That's not how we do job interviews. I didn't apply for a job with you. You did. I didn't. You did. I didn't. Okay, you know what? This has been whatever, but I don't do blind dates, so ask me who I work for. What? You really want to ask me who I work for? Fine. Who do you work for? Chairs in Pairs Dual Chair Manufacturing. Chairs in Pairs Dual Chair Manufacturing? The Chairs in Pairs Dual Chair Manufacturing? Wait, shut up. Is this a ploy to keep me on this date? This is not a blind date. When I buy you dinner, then you'll know I'm interested. You did apply for a job with me. The way I know you applied for a job with me is that I have your resume on my Android tablet device. The way I know you would kill puppies to get this job is the way you stopped breathing when I said Chairs and Pairs Dual Chair Manufacturing, which is a tell, your tell, and you should look at that, because I'm going to offer you a crap salary and you'll have to take it. Because somehow you never really learned how to breathe in and out without stopping. But don't feel bad, because we all get paid crap salaries, because we're the good guys. I'm a good guy, which means I generally don't lie, but I just did to you. This is not a job interview. Wait, I'm confused. Chairs and Pairs Dual Chair Manufacturing already told me to hire you. The job is yours. The best job you'll ever have. You'll change lives, slay dragons, love the hunt more than you ever imagined. Because Chairs and Pairs Dual Chair Manufacturing is as amazing as they say. And I'm not a baby. I'm a gladiator in a suit. Because that's what you are when you work for Chairs and Pairs Dual Chair Manufacturing. You're a gladiator in a suit. Do you want to be a gladiator in a suit? You have to say it. I want to be a Chairs and Pairs Dual Chair Manufacturing gladiator in a suit. Flashback to yesterday. It sits, but it sits itself, so don't worry about it. To reiterate at this point that it sits, but it sits itself, so don't worry about it. I just feel like I'm a little bit worried. Flash forward to tomorrow.
Trending topic. Chairs and Pairs Dual Chair Manufacturing announces plans to begin only manufacturing singular chairs. Social media accounts disappear without notice.
I don't need to know. We do
Intermission. So we're going to have a 15-minute intermission. Do you want to say anything?
I was going to say that it's tonic water time. Are you guys having a good time so far? Great. Yeah, this is our break. In the intermission, we're going to show a sculpture
by Connor Crawford. It will be up here. And you can also check out our merch. There's a poster on that wall by Ray Chang from Miami. It's a poster of his poems. And what else can you look
before
at?
Before we go on, Kiel, do you want to say something about Ray?
Ray's someone I know from Weird Facebook, and I wasn't expecting to see them here today. And yeah, it's pretty cool. Weird
Facebook. Pretty cool, pretty cool.
Pretty cool.
Also, merch for sale. If you look at the back of the room, there's a beach towel taped to the wall. That is a Bugs brand beach towel. It's for sale, too.
And designed by Laura McCoy.
And so, yeah. Great. See you soon.
Okay, see you in a bit.
Kick to the base of this energy. Thank you.
Check, check, check. Is that coming out? Check.
Hello.
Check.
Checking my mic. All right,
we're back.
Is my mic on? Yes.
Welcome
back. Welcome back.
Great.
Okay, so welcome back.
Roll off that.
We're going to start the second half with a grocery giveaway. We do this every month. So basically, you have a number on your program, and that will determine whether or not you win this month's grocery giveaway, which has been selected by Cam Lee, who is also a camera. Cam.
Opera man. Okay. We'll keep this moving along. So here's what we got. We have one of these. we got one of these.
This is salt that's been specially prepared by Cam. It's seasoned salt.
This is a bag of rice that is in very shiny paper. It's like a pajama material color.
Special spice mix prepared by Cam, which you can use to make this dish.
Pure cream coconut. Coconut.
Tofu. Okay. Licorice.
One of these.
Parsnip. Green onion.
Three of these.
Ginger.
This purse falling on my shoe. Don't eat that.
This stuff.
Nobody eat this.
Great. Okay, so I'm going to generate a number on my phone, random number. Number is 21. Who's the winner?
We
Come
have
on
a
up.
Winner. Let's hear it for Ben.
Okay.
Great. Round of applause for Ben, everybody.
There you go, Ben.
And we're back. I guess we stall now. Tell a joke.
Talk about the song that you heard over there.
The song that I heard earlier today? I don't know if I can do that joke very well. Okay, fine. Okay, sure. I heard a song on Virgin Radio. And the chorus was like, we'll travel to places where you can't even pronounce the name. Or something like that. Well, like, I'll take you places you can't even pronounce the name. Like, that's the chorus of the song. It's a song for losers. That's why it's supposed to be a joke. What? Did I tell that joke right?
Yes, that was great. Thank you, John.
Thank you. Okay. Thank you.
So our first act of the second half is Laura McCoy.
pebbles and or stones. Pebbles and or beads. Pebbles and or beads. Brown. Stones and or balls.
Let's hear it for Laura McCoy, everybody. Also, I happen to know Laura's quite sick. So that's more reason to applaud. Right? Right?
You're right. I heard something on the radio, which was this ad that was like, ladies, get your balls, your lady balls fixed. Like, come in and check out your ovaries for cysts.
What station was that on?
I don't know. AM radio. I don't know.
You listen to AM radio? I listen to Boom FM. So that's the end of our stall material.
Okay. Our next act is Humboldt Magnusson.
Hello. So, I recently went home for Christmas. It was lots of fun. Me and my sister, we had a turkey, and I saw my parents, and I saw my father on the 27th, and unfortunately, he disowned me, which was, like, I know what everyone's thinking. It's like, you know, it's obviously because I'm gay, but it's not because I'm gay. It's like a completely normal disownment. and not a sad disownment, just like a really normal one. So then I went, I had a really good Christmas, and I went back to Toronto where I live, and I saw my friends and family, and I told them that I was disowned, and they were like, oh, like, I'm surprised you're not having a breakdown. You have a breakdown over everything. And I'm like, no, I haven't had a breakdown. And now, what's today's date? So it's the 22nd, so it's been quite a while. And I was talking to my friend this morning, and he was telling me, like, oh, I really think you need to let it go. I think you need to, like, express yourself. I think you need to, like, vent and, like, you know, like, process this disownment. So I have about 5 minutes left of my performance. And Amy, do you mind if you just find this? So I need everyone to help me out. So this is going to be interactive, so if you want to participate, I need two participants. I'll call you up soon. But you can help me out by, like saying encouraging words, like, no one loves you, as well as, like, boo-hoo. So as you can tell, I'm shaking. It's not because I'm nervous. It's because I have hand tremors. That's the only thing my dad ever gave me. So I'm just going to get John. Do you want to help me out? So me and my dad are similar in only a couple things. We're both tall, and he's balding, and I'm balding, which is true. And so something that you find out when you have an absent father is people are always worried that you're not going to grow up to be a real man, and they try to encourage you to, like, they're, like, worried that they're not going to, like, play football or go fishing or shave, that you'll never know how to shave. And so that's something that I'm going to explore right now. I don't understand. Do you want to come with me? I don't understand why people think I can't shave, that I'll just... Oh, yeah, that's helpful. That I'll never be able to shave. And Amy, can you just... I only have 5 minutes. Oh, minutes? Yeah. Can
4 minutes.
Okay. Can I get the 2 volunteers? Like, I really need you guys to help me out. Vent. 2 volunteers, come up to the stage. Please. Can you guys stand on either side of me? You guys are wearing ponchos because I don't want you to get covered in tears. Because I'm going to cry a lot. So I'm always very confused what people think, what will happen when, like, a sad 14-year-old that doesn't know how to shave without a father, how he's going to do it. So I have hand tremors. So I'm going to need you guys to just tape on these shaving creams onto my hands. You too. Okay, great. Wait. Sorry. Okay, we'll just work on... Okay. Okay.
3 minutes.
Oh, my goodness. Okay. Okay, thank you. Just stand here. And you have to look sad. Please look sad and bored, because I'm sad. Okay, so... I just don't understand what they would think would happen. Like, you know, obviously I don't know how to use a razor. And then... So, I think what they think is that I just... You know, start crying hysterically because I don't have a father. Does anyone who has fathers, like, want to give me any advice? Any advice? No? Okay. So this is what I think they think that I would do. Like, I'm imagining I'm 14. So I kind of, like, shoot it out like Spider-Man, right? And then I just shake it up. Ugh, it's not coming because I don't have a father. Okay, and then I just scoop. Hand tremors.
2 minutes.
And then I shave, right? Okay, can you guys please yell boo-hoo with me? Boo-hoo! I'm so sad, I never learned how to shave. Okay, this isn't working, so please take me out.
I thought I saw a man brought to life. He was warm, he came around like he was dignified. He showed me what it was to cry. Well, you couldn't be that man I adore. You don't seem to know, you seem to care what your heart is for. I don't know him anymore. There's nothing where he used to lie. The conversation has run dry.
Humboldt Magnuson. Thank you, Humboldt. John got shaving cream all over himself. I guess we have to stall. So I think we have a new gel for our spotlight. Is that right, Inez?
Oh, yeah.
Let's check it out. Thank you, Inez. Okay, our next act is Lisa Smolkin.
Are you a part of things? I was wondering if I'm a part of things. So I made this. Twitter. Texting. Get a friend request. That's fun. Unfriend. Block. That's the worst.
And now, the drama continues on The Bachelor.
I think that as honest as you've been with me about your feelings, I have to be honest with you about mine and tell you that today I can't give you this rose. I'm gonna have to say goodbye.
I've just hurt a lot throughout this process, but I never let it get to me because I was always so focused on Ben.
Saying goodbye to Olivia was not easy. Emotion this week was a roller coaster, and as much as I want to talk to these women at a cocktail party, for the first time, just don't feel like I have it in me. I feel a little discouraged after this week. I feel alone. Maybe at the end of this, I won't find love.
Holy moly. Is there like a hurricane going on?
It's almost like the weather has predicted this whole week.
Tonight's the most nervous I've been going into a cocktail party because Ben had heard from someone in the house that I'm very different around him. I won't feel better until Ben and I have a conversation and I can truly be reassured that he like does trust me.
I mean, I was heartbroken after my last relationship. I loved the person that I was with, and I was heartbroken.
We should go downstairs.
I'm honestly very scared to open myself again.
Loss. Friendship. Are you a part of things? Very scared. What are you feeling right now? Can you see me? Why? But why? Are you a part of things? Are you a part of things? Social treachery. Fun. Uncomfortable. Alone. Rejected. Rejected. Are you a part of things? Very scared. Can this get better? What's happening? What's happening? Hey, hi, how's it going? Are you a part of things? 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 Social treachery. Social treachery. Why don't I understand what is happening? Why is it so painful? It's painful. Can you feel the pain too? Are our feelings connected? What are your feelings? Where is the room for my feelings and what I think? I'm not sure about this. Do you love me? Am I a part of things? If I wasn't here, would you miss me? Do you miss me right now? Can you feel that I'm actually not here right now? Can you feel that? Why am I here? Why aren't you looking at me right now? Why are you not looking at me right now? Am I a part of things? I know my vulnerability makes you uncomfortable. Am I a part of things? Will you accept this rose? Do you like flowers? I do. What's your favorite kind of flower? Roses? Are you a part of things? Very scared. The scared. Very scared. Very scared. What makes you feel scared? I hope things are going to get better. Do we have to be grateful for what we have in order for things to get better? How does this work? Will you accept this rose?
I'm sorry about tonight. I think we can all say it's been a long week. Tonight, coming into this, I just didn't feel like it was appropriate to add a cocktail party to it. I thought it would add a confusion and it would just make this process and this week even tougher. I'm trying to find out how to do this and find love and find the woman for me. But that leads me into tonight, and there's not a question that this will be the hardest rose ceremony.
Let's hear it for Lisa Smolkin, everybody.
Lisa made that video with the help of Dan Goodbaum and the poster with Scott Lubser, she wanted me to say.
All right. Well, now it's time for Neil. This is Neil's last door ever because he's moving to Korea. So that's the end of that sentence. Well, Dord only goes for 30 episodes.
No.
Dord's only going to 30 episodes because we don't want to do this forever.
It's going to end in December 2016. But Neil isn't leaving until April, he told me.
So he'll be at the next Dord.
Maybe.
Well, great. Good enough for Dord.
Okay, Neil.
Historians argued for years exactly what happened that night in Kensington Market, debating what the precise movements or lack of movements may have been. They spent their entire careers dedicated to recrafting that 15-second opera that was mislabeled a ballet by Baby. The passion, the drama, the 15-second opera that was mislabeled a ballet, and the baby behind it all. Neil Appiah stars in Baby's Ballet. Coming up right now on BBC Two. No, baby. It is I that should bow to you. Don't be intimidated by me. Just because I appeared in several art periodicals, such as Canadian Art, C Magazine, artinamerica.com, and I'm in the current issue as a profiled artist in Visual Arts News, The Playful Plane. People Pain of Neil Appiah by Jonathan Rothstein, on sale now. And just because I'm a grant awarded artist doesn't mean that I'm not humbled by your presence. Please, baby, tell me about your new ballet. They say that ballet is supposed to be the soul escaping the body through dance. But that you're subverting that. And it's all about the body keeping the soul prison. You, emotionless, your eyes wide open, your mouth also wide open. Like a beautiful statue, a motionless ballet. They said that your last ballet was your swan song, and now you are a dead swan, and your future ballet will be a dead swan and the gases escaping the different holes of the swan. And that I want to see it. I can't watch made-for-TV docudramas about it anymore. I have to go there. Take me to that night. Take me there, baby. Sorry, baby. Just 1 second. Okay, we're good. Okay, check, check. 1, 2, check, check. Hello, 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 hello. Check, check, check. Hello, hello. Okay, our next performer is Baby. All right, wrap it in, wrap it in, wrap it in, guys. Come on, come on, come on. I know. No, not you guys.
Bring it in, bring it in. Okay? I know you guys like to do ballet on your break, and I'm sorry to cut into your 15-minute coffee break, but here at Day Job, we have a very important thing we have to do. So you know I hate cutting into your time. I don't want to waste my time. You don't want to waste your time. So let's just get started at this. What I want to do, it's called a problem-solving quest. It's a wonderful workshop. Quest has two different meanings. One, it's short for the word question. Two, it is the word quest. So let's get started with how we can set it up so that people can actually clap for the ballets that take place at Double Double Land. Everyone's going to be drinking beer or something like that. And let's just assume that everybody's right-handed. Okay, if that's too much for you, let's assume that we at least are in a world where everybody favors using their right hand. Maybe they are left-handed, but because the world is set up to use your right hand when you drink, it's a lot easier, so left-handed people have also learned to do that. And you have these cup holders, and you have a space that you can attach cup holders on the right-hand side. What do you do? Janine Garofalo walks into UCB East. She's so casual, like she's dressed casual, she's acting casual, and then of course all the other stand-up comedians that came there for the women-only night, women-only open mic night, and then they're all like, everyone's like super tense and freaking out. Like Janine Garofalo just walks in, and then Janine Garofalo, like, does she need to put her name in the bucket? No. Does she need to talk to the girl that's pulling the names out of the bucket that she doesn't need to do it? Like, come on, just let me. No. She just walks in and she just does it, and she asks, is anybody here a millennial? And then this girl is like, yeah. And she's like, what's your deal? She kind of did something like that. And then she said, are you a celiac? Or are you lactose intolerant? What's your like food sensitivity? Because millennials have more food sensitivity than the generation before them. And I was there with my friend Kat Toledo, who I met at Dort, and she was kind of holding my hand all week. We were going to these open mic things, and it was really, really nice. But it was like, we were doing like, they do like four or five open mic night things a week, and it's really intense. So it was like, I don't want to do any more open mics right now. I'm kind of sick of that. So then we were like, let's go to the bar where Janine Garofalo is performing at, right after we saw Janine Garofalo. And then Janine Garofalo was like, any millennials in the audience? And then this guy's like, woo! And she's like, oh, what's your deal? And she made like a joke about millennials having food sensitivity. And then Kat Toledo like let go of my hand, and I went into the bar, and I went to go buy a beer, and they were $2, and everybody was paying $3. So I went to go pay $3, but I had two $1 bills and four quarters. And she was like, don't give me this. Like I want paper money. Like, bring me paper money. What's wrong with you? What am I supposed to do with this? And I felt like I like didn't really fit in. And it was I felt like I should go back to Canada. And then I performed at this show, and it was the whole reason I went to New York was to perform in this show in Williamsburg. And then they booed me in Williamsburg, and it was so awful. But then at least like Lisa Smokin was also doing that same show, and she killed, and she really like represented Dord really well and Dord Toronto. And then it was like this year I got to go back. And John was there, and Amy was there, and Glenn was there, and Randy was there, and... Oh, man. I think Seth was there, and Des and Cal were there. Charlie and Sebastian were there. Lisa was there, and Bridget was there. And it was the first time I saw Bridget perform. She, like, was putting these chairs on top of each other, and she was saying, like, it seats itself. And then, even though, like... As a performer, like, personally, she's obviously, like, not evolved. That's your opinion. But she, I think that it's been, like, so incredible, like, seeing her, you know, like, turn into this, like, amazing performer that does, like, all this super, super tight stuff all the freaking time. And John and Amy, I made a list of people I love, and it's really short. And, I want you to know that, you're both on it, even though you're famous Hollywood directors now, and everyone's like really sick of you and really sick of talking about bugs and stuff. Everybody's moved on. And baby, I know I'm always terrible at ending these things, but it's over, and thank you, goodbye.
you, Neil. I love you too.
Let's get Neil out one last time. Come on up, Neil.
Neil! And
missed that opportunity there, Dan.
And Lisa has a special gift for Neil.
Woo!
I'm gonna go open it in private.
Let's hear it for opening it in private.
It's lip balm.
Wow. And that's the end of the show. So thanks for coming to Doored 23, everybody.
Yay. Yeah.
That's it.
Next Doored is in April. See you then.
And now, do you want to turn on the spotlight?
I'm really sorry for making you feel so bad. I'm really sorry.